20 cold cases were revived in a week-long facial reconstruction class held at the USF Institute for Forensic Anthropology and Applied Science.
We look for cases that need the most sort of help, those that don't have DNA profiles on file, those that need chemical isotope testing and facials, and that will really benefit from everything that science has to offer.
Dr. Kimberly's team uses found remains to determine details such as age, sex, and ancestry. Then forensic artists use these profiles to recreate the faces of unsolved cases. It's a balance of science and art.
I've been working on a white female, unidentified, 25 to 35 years old. It's a strange one, this one, because she was found without a mandible, so they had to reconstruct the jaw in proportion to the cranium.
3D printing technology allows artists to use skull replicas as the foundation.
So mine is from 1979, from this area, from Tampa. She's a black female, age 20 to 35, and her skull was only partially present, so the anthropologist team here has reconstructed it digitally and then printed her out for me.
The focus of the workshop is to reveal the final bust to the public at the Art of Forensics event.
There are boxes and boxes of unsolved cases that still need answers.
Joe Mullins of the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children created this course in hopes that someone may recognize a face.
I stop when I see somebody staring back at me. That's how it works. You know you're done when you step back, you set your scoping tools down, and I'm gonna have a 13-year-old's, you know, face, little boy staring back at me.
For USF News, I'm Sandra Roa.